And we are joined by Chris McGuthrie right now. And they say it's a big man's game, but this small guy had over 2,200 points in his career. You are the only player to be named on either first or second team All-NEC four consecutive years. So what's the first thing that came flashing back into your mind when you got the call that you were going into the Hall of Fame?
Well, the first thing was, this is probably the most special award that I've ever won. It doesn't just represent the school or myself, but it's from the whole entire conference. So for me, this was like a big, big deal. I normally don't reach out to many people to support me, but I did this time because it was such a special honor.
You know, you got honored at halftime, and our viewers, I don't think, saw it. So you made a tremendous speech, and you really paid tribute to, you see you and your wife now, they're on the screen. I think you overachieved there too, by the way. You paid special tribute to Coach Phelan. Tell our viewers what Coach Phelan meant to you.
Well, first of all, he gave me the opportunity to set these type of records because he let me play from the get-go. He used to get on me about not shooting the ball. Instead of shooting too much, he told me shoot more. And that's special because if he didn't allow me to do that, then this honor would not have been possible.
Yeah, Chris, for a second. Mount Paul continues to dominate inside. Opoku that time, one of two, extended the lead to two. Now, your biggest win as a player here at Mount, what was it?
It's got to be Georgia Tech or East Carolina.
Wow, two big-time wins. And what do you remember about that game?
The Georgia Tech game, I remember Stephon Marbury.
Well, he was pretty good.
Yeah, he was the number two pick. He poked me in my ribs and said, hey, man, you never miss. Ironically, I played against his brother at St. Francis when he played at St. Francis, New York.
Donald Marbury.
Yes.
Yes. Now, you played overseas. Tell our viewers, how many years you play and where'd you play?
I played for 10 years.
Wow.
Six in Amsterdam. I played in Spain, Croatia, and Israel. And I had two kids born, one born in Spain and one born in Amsterdam.
Did you meet your wife overseas, or is she a Mount girl?
She speaks six languages, but I met her in high school.
That's six more languages that I speak. Now, you dabbled in coaching for a little bit, right?
Yes, I coached the Springbrook High School boys basketball team, but I have kids of my own, and I need to watch them grow, too.
Good for you. You know, I actually coached for 25 years, and my first coaching job at Fairfield for 7 years, I quit because I wanted to be a real dad. So I stayed home, and I went to work for Converse, but I missed the coaching so much. Your thoughts as we watch this great game, and the young Mount team is really putting up a great fight, you know, against this preseason number one pick, St. Francis. Your thoughts on this Mount team, Chris?
I like the way they move the ball. I know they have a lot of young guys. My best friend, Darren McClinton, who's standing underneath of the opposite basket that they're at right now, he actually trained four of the players that are out here, two St. Francis players and two Mount St. Mary players, most notably Votto, who he worked with very extensively.
Well, let's give him a plug. Does he have a coaching academy, or is he just does it on his own, or does he work for a particular program or organization?
He trains down at Bullis High School.
Okay.
He's a trainer for many of their athletic teams, and he's been personal basketball training for a while. He trains pros, college players. Everybody knows him from this area. He's the best.
We are here with Chris McGuthrie, Mount St. Mary's legend and newest inductee into the Northeast Conference Hall of Fame. 95, you go to the NCAAs. 96, you went to the NIT. 96, you were the NEC Player of the Year. With so many different things that were happening to you, how did you keep your head so on straight? Because it's obvious that everybody looked up to you as a leader and as a class act, and they have so much respect for you. You know, sometimes it can get a little difficult with all those good things happening to somebody.
Well, one really great thing that happened to me was Riley Inge, who was a very good, good player, all-conference player. He came in and took the leadership role, and that just allowed me to focus on, hey, Chris, you go out and score the ball, and that's what I did. Riley Inge was a passer. He was an all-around player, and he allowed me to do those things. He freed me. I wasn't a good leader when I was young.
Now, never would have known it. Because you really developed into one.
You look at Chung Kwee out here for the Mountaineers. He's 5'8 walk-on. He's been effective all year. He leads the conference in assist-to-turnover ratio. You were not offered another scholarship other than Mount St. Mary's. So tell our young viewers what you went through and what advice you would give to them, for especially the young, the smaller players who are not being given that attention. What advice would you give them?
The advice that Lefty Driesell gave to myself and Darren McClinton: if you're not practicing, someone else is. And later on when you meet, they're going to win. So if you're practicing as much as you can, that's all you can do to put yourself in the position to be successful.
Tied at 49 with just under 13 minutes to go in this one. That is Thompson for three, rebounded by Namine. As we look up to the left, Chris, your number 50 is retired. It's up on that wall. What kind of goes through your mind when you see your retired number as you walk into a building like that?
Well, it's very special. I come up here all the time in the summer, and for me, it's special that my kids across the way and their friends get to see that, because I'm daddy to them, and on these type of days, I get to become an actual person.
Are there any VHS tapes at home? I know today it's Blu-ray, but when you were playing, it was VHS tapes. Do you ever get to pop some of them in and show them, like, hey, this is what I did?
Yes, I do, and I do have one or two. However, the kids only have an attention span of about 1 minute and 37 seconds.
Yeah, that is a problem. Do you still play?
I don't. I've had some problems with my back and different
issues. I hear that.
To the free throw line for the Mountaineers will be Jalen Gibbs, as the foul goes on Keith Braxton. He's picking up his first and the team's fourth. Gibbs now, by the way, with 7 points, and it's a 50-49 Mount St. Mary's lead.
Chris, Paul and I come down here once, a couple of times a year to broadcast games, and we're always intrigued and appreciative of the way we're treated by these people. I could just, when you gave your speech, I got a little emotional. I know you did too, and I bet a lot of people. What did these fans mean to you?
They were so supportive. I remember wherever I went locally, they would always help me with my bill, give me free food. Because as a college player, you don't have any money. And it's just, they treat you as if you're in a large town and as if you're somebody. And that's very nice of them. The emails I received are just so uplifting.
Of course, this is an outstanding facility, too. I have to tell you, it's one of the best in the conference, and the people really seem to electrify the building for big games like this.
Yeah, they do, and that's one of the reasons why I never had a thought of leaving Mount St. Mary's. When someone likes you, stay. And a lot of the players nowadays aren't doing that.
We'll talk about staying power. Your legend stays. Jim Phelan's legend stays. So many other memories stay. Thank you so much for stopping by. Chris McGuthrie of the NEC Hall of Fame.
Thanks for having me.